Senator Anthony Chanona got up and said, after his insistence, he was allowed to see it at 9:15 or 9:30, I don't remember when it was, and he read it. Then you have disenfranchised further the rest of us in there and disrespected us to say, you know, well, one of yours can go in there and tell you, yes, he has seen it and he's satisfied. That is absolutely no comfort to me.
I would have thought it was made the whole meeting invalid.
Right. I would have thought so too.
You don't have all the information?
Yes. And as far as I'm concerned, all I was saying is, if you think that there are matters in there that you cannot make public, sequester the Senate. There is no provision in standing orders, but we are honorable people. Bring the agreement, put it in committee, let us see what is said in committee. Committee is private in any case. You kick the media out when there is a committee meeting. You kick the gallery, you clear the gallery. Bring the agreement, show us, put a final date on us so we all can be satisfied. This is upfront, above board, and legitimate. I made the point in the Senate that indeed the lands transferred at Boom from Intelco are sold, let me use the right word, sold to BTL as part of the recovery of part of the Intelco debt for a reported $19 million or thereabouts. I don't know, I knew that the cash was not paid up front, so I don't know the status of that liability from BTL to government. I don't know where it is, and nobody probably knows where it is except Mr. Gandhi. So that is one liability in favor of the government of Belize. There is also the sunshine issue of $20 million. We don't know where that is also. Is there anything for the transferor, the transferee to say, I don't want to hold those liabilities. Those are BTL liabilities, you hold that.
Right.
And when government tries to collect that, now, well, BTL has no assets, it's just there. I mean,
there's a piece of paper.